Good afternoon and welcome to the Peter Darrell Studio here at Scottish Ballet HQ. Behind me today, the dancers are rehearsing five tangos, part of our autumn season triple bill. Today, Scottish Ballet's new Artistic Director, Christopher Hampson, will be leading you through the rehearsal, giving an insight into the piece. After about 20 minutes of rehearsal, I'll be putting your questions to Christopher. You can ask them now on Scottish Ballet's Facebook or on Twitter using the hashtag SBAutumnSeason. I'll pass you now over to Christopher and I hope you enjoy the rehearsal.
Thanks very much, Laura. Welcome to the rehearsal. As Laura mentioned, this is five tangos. You've joined us at a really serendipitous moment because we're just finishing teaching the entire ballet. As the title suggests, five tangos has got five tangos in it. What we're seeing behind us is the fifth tango, the very last one, and we're just working on the finale now, and our guest teacher Maya Venema and Roland Price have just finished setting the very final pose for the company. Just while they're putting the finishing touches to that, I thought I'd just take a bit of time to tell you about Five Tangos itself. The choreographer is Hans van Manen. He's a real great choreographer and a Dutch choreographer. He created this work in 1977 to the music of Astor Piazzolla. The five tangos that comprise the work explore the different themes and qualities to the tango. It's not a narrative work, but there's really clear emotions and themes running through. The tango starts with everybody on stage. That's seven couples, seven men, seven women. So that's 14 of our dancers. And each tango has a different combination of dancers, ranging from the second tango, which is all men and one female principal, through to the third tango, which is just for a principal male. The fourth tango has a very peculiar, curious quality. It's predominantly for two men dancing together, and they are then interrupted when two ladies join, and it becomes a quartet. And then we reach the fifth tango, which is the finale, which you can see behind me. We're really lucky to be working with Maya Venema, who is Hans's assistant, and she was actually in the original cast of Five Tangos back in 1977. So there's a wonderful lineage that she's here to be teaching our dancers at Scottish Ballet for their premiere of Five Tangos. I'm just going to step out the way for 2 minutes while we have a look around the studio and see what's happening. You'll see at the front of the studio, standing to our left, is Maya Venema. She has taught the dancers from her notebook, which she started making when she first work with Hans. She's been taking the dancers through their paces for the last week and a half, and this is our final week of rehearsals before we hit the theatre next week.
Thank you.
So the dancers, though they've been working with Maya on the other tangos, this is really what I call wet paint. They haven't touched this until probably about 20 minutes before we came on air, so to speak. You'll see Maya demonstrating the particular moves that Hans van Manen will want to see when he joins us next week to stage the work. It's a very particular style. It's very slick. It's quite minimalist in its movement. So the dancers have to be incredibly precise and very clear musically. From here on in, it's really a constant process of refining the movement, making sure the musicality is the same throughout the company. And eventually, once the dancers are really comfortable with the vocabulary, they'll be bringing to it their own sense of passion to the performance. Working with Maya right now is Roland Price. Roland Price is a former principal with Birmingham Royal Ballet. Roland has danced the lead role in Five Tangos many times, and the first time I ever worked with Roland as a ballet master was on this production. So there's another line of history that brings Five Tangos to Scottish Ballet. At the front of this line, you'll see Claire Robertson, our principal dancer, and Christopher Harrison, who's a soloist with the company. They'll be performing the principal roles in Five Tangos, opening in Glasgow next Thursday on the 4th of October. It's necessary for us to be able to put the best casts on stage for you to see. It's necessary that we field more than one cast. So the dancers towards the back of the studio will be learning particular roles that you're seeing being performed in front. It's a bit like a subs bench in a football match, if you like. So if someone's injured, we know that we can put someone else on. And also, it gives the opportunity for the company to perform a variety of roles throughout the season so that they're not performing one role 10 or 20 times. So it keeps it interesting for them and hopefully for you too, which means you can come back and see us twice. Roland is working with Brenda and Remy. In the second cast of Five Tangos, so on alternative nights, Remy is performing in the fourth tango, which is the male duet.
So you really finish here until you take a step back. Let's do it all three together, because actually that's the most important, that you all move exactly the same.
As well as learning what they're learning in front of us now, the dancers also have in their heads two other works that we'll be performing as part of the Autumn Triple Bill. The first is Run For It by Martin Lawrence, that was created for part of the Dance GB project, which accompanied the Cultural Olympiad in summer this year. So it's going to make a welcome return to our autumn season so that the rest of Scotland can see that production. And the second ballet that we're presenting is by William Forsyth, called Work Within Work. This is a really beautiful lyrical work set to a score by Berio. And it really stretches the company in terms of movement dynamic and concentration and performance, as some of the work within work is improvised. So it sounds like Maya's going to allow us to see a full run of the very last tango. Please bear in mind that it is wet paint, so the dancers have just learnt this. So it'll be a little raw in places, but you'll get a flavour of the finale to five tangos. So you see the dancers lining up here in the wings in front of us, ready to make their first entrance.
Ready?
Okay, so you've that was a pretty good run through considering they've just learnt it. I'm just going to see if I can grab Maya for a quick chat, if you just hold on. Maya, can I borrow you for a minute, Roland, if you want to? So, Maya, thanks so much for letting us see that.
Sure,
this is Maya Vane, and I wanted to ask you, just telling everyone that you were in the original cast of Five Tangos.
Many, many years ago.
Can you tell us what the experience is like working with Hans at that time?
Well, we knew immediately. I had done many ballets with him already, but you felt that he was very inspired by Piazzolla's music. It was something so new. And of course, always the rhythm, what he worked on. And especially, I remember when he thought of this ending, that the separation of the couples, you know, we felt immediately it was great.
And did you know the Piazzolla music before Hans used it?
No, it was then he was not known at all in Europe.
Right.
It was, I think, well, he was the first one. Also, Piazzolla mentioned it when he came to a concert in Amsterdam, that he thanked Hans van Manen for using his music.
Fantastic. Look, Mayor, I don't want to keep you from rehearsal.
But it's still so fresh, though. They just learned it.
Yeah. I've explained that.
But it's wonderful to work with these dancers, I must say.
Oh, that's great. Thanks so much, Mayor. Cheers. Okay. Thank you. So we'll let Mayor get back to rehearsing the other four tangos out of the five. And I believe we're ready to hand back to Laura for your questions.
Thank you very much, Chris. That was wonderful to watch. We have had some questions come in online. So I will start with, we've had one asking, how long is the rehearsal period for a sort of triple bill, for example?
That varies depending on the sorts of ballets we're doing. Essentially, these one-act works that are roughly between 20 and 30 minutes, they'll take about 3 weeks of rehearsal to pull together. Often the dancers will be taught the vocabulary and the text, if you like, and then it takes a while for their bodies to adapt to that way of moving, and it's really that takes the time before the performance. So I would say for this program, we've been rehearsing 6 weeks in total.
Here we go, hope that's answered that question. And we have another question that's asking, what happens if one of the dancers become injured during performance? I think you sort of touched on that by mentioning double cast.
Yeah, obviously that's really not something we want to happen, but it does happen, like in any physical activity, there might be an injury. So we do have dancers that know each other's roles, so someone can step in last minute. The dancers really take care of their bodies. I mean, they are God's athletes, as it was described once. So they're very adept at making sure that their bodies are really, really in peak condition at all times. So we try and prevent injuries rather than have them.
Definitely. And this was asking sort of from a choreographer's point of view, how do you decide which pieces to select for a triple bill?
Oh, that goes down as one of the nicest bits of my job. Curating the work and finding work that I think will both suit the dancers, broaden the repertoire, and give you, the audience, a really great night at the theatre. That's the sort of ingredients I look for a triple bill in choosing the ballets. And obviously, choreographers that are not only masters in their own right, but new voices coming through, like Martin Lawrence, it's very important to represent them too. So I think that's one of the best bits of my job, actually, choosing repertoire.
We've got another one coming online. It's asking what you're most enjoying about your role so far at Scottish Ballet.
Okay, oh, lots actually. I love living in Glasgow. I'm working with a great group of dancers, and it's been a really good time these last 6 weeks putting this programme together, where I'm getting to know the dancers and they're getting to know me too. I think just making sure I get to know what this organisation's really great at and showing you guys what that is. That's the best bit of the job so far. But more to come, I'm sure.
Thank you very much. I think that's all the questions we've had online. So thank you very much for joining us today in our Peter Darrell Studios for this Five Tangos rehearsal. We hope you enjoyed, and we hope to see you again at our next webcast. Thank you.